The internet is full of supposed tips and tricks to achieve a first-time IVF success. At Infertility TV, we will explore whether using heparin is helpful in achieving first-time IVF success. The first question to answer is, why was heparin even recommended for IVF? Heparins are a group of medications which are primarily used to reduce the chance for blood clots to form in blood vessels. Some studies found a relationship between blood clots forming in the uterus and the risk of miscarriage or recurrent miscarriage. In addition, some women have a medical problem called thrombophilia, which means they are at greater risk for having blood clots form. As a result, some doctors started using heparin in couples with recurrent miscarriage, especially those with thrombophilias, with some success. This led to the question of whether using heparins would also improve the chance for implantation in patients attempting pregnancy with IVF. A number of studies have been published which have tried to answer this question, and the results have been mixed. This means that some studies showed a benefit to using heparin, and some studies found no benefit. This happens fairly often in medicine, where studies reach different conclusions. One way to figure out what is going on is to combine all of the smaller studies into one very big study. This is called a meta-analysis. Think of it this way. Doctors can be more confident about the results of a study if you have 1,000 patients compared to, say, 100. Meta-analyses can also weed out studies that were not of very good quality. So, what's the Infertility TV bottom line? In 2018, a meta-analysis of 5 high-quality studies involving nearly 1,000 total patients found no benefit in using heparin for IVF. Women given heparins during their IVF cycle didn't get pregnant more often, they didn't miscarry less, and they didn't have a baby more often than women who didn't use heparins. This study did not find a benefit even in couples that had 2 previous failed IVF cycles or 3 previous failed IVF cycles. And one important thing to note is that these studies looked specifically at women who did not have a thrombophilia, a blood clotting problem. Make sure you check out this playlist for more first-time IVF success tips. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Have a question? Leave it in the comments below. Click the link in the description to become a new patient, or just subscribe to get new episodes weekly. It's like having an infertility specialist in your phone.